Good morning, everyone. Welcome to our Reign of Christ Sunday, and we're also calling it our Celebration of Music Sunday. And I can tell from the anticipation of the folks who are here that you are pretty excited about having some special music today. I want to welcome those who are joining us on through live stream. Those on live stream may not be able to see where I am, but I'm kind of in the corner on the side of the platform because we're about to fill this space with musicians. A couple of announcements that I want to make. First of all, in your bulletin today and also attached to the Grace Weekly News, there is an insert that includes information getting ready for Advent. And there's a number of projects identified in there. If you want to help us with getting the church decorated and the outside lights up or helping to set up our labyrinth, there's a lot of things that you can be involved in if you would like to help us out during Advent. The other thing I want to mention is there's some projects coming up, and some of those are identified in our Grace Weekly News, including a rally this Tuesday for those who are homeless that will be held down in Heritage Park in Barrie to acknowledge the fact that we have some folks who so far have not been provided any shelter for the winter, and we want to try and speed that process up a little. So please come join us on Tuesday. Our Charlie Brown tree is out in the foyer for mittens and socks and underwear. And two weeks from now, there'll be an amnesty letter writing event after church. So a number of actions to be taken, as well as helping out with things. So please hang on to the Grace Weekly News and read it for information. We're being invited to an Advent challenge by our outreach team, and on here is a list of an item for every day of Advent that you might contribute to our food pantry outside or to our food inside that will also be distributed around various agencies. If you want a bag to put items in, and then maybe bring the bag in once a week with those items. And I also want to mention that our food fair yesterday was very successful. We raised $4,927. Now here's the thing, there's always an and that goes with this, right? $4,927 isn't quite $5,000. So there's baking out in the foyer that is still available. If you would like to have some baking and pick that up on the way out, I'm sure there'll be someone to take your money. And there's frozen cabbage rolls still available too, and meat pies. So on your way out, stop and have a look at the table or talk to Mary. And finally, in a couple minutes, we're going to introduce the Baytowne Big Band, but I want to acknowledge Sarang Kulkarni, who is here today with the band, and they'll be coming in a few minutes after we do our opening call to worship and introit. So let us worship. Hallelujah, sing to God a brand new song. Praise God in the company of all who love God. Let them praise God's name with dancing. Strike up the band and make great music. Let us sing for joy. We're going to do an introit by the choir, and the choir can't quite get up on the platform today, so as they're coming forward to the steps, I want to say a word about the introit. As you know, during COVID, we have not been able to sing. And some of us went for a couple of years not being able to really just get out and sing and enjoy the music. And I know it was very hard for people who were musical. Even during our worship services, we were led by a couple of musicians, but we were told not to sing. And so as we came towards the end of that time when singing was allowed, a composer named Lydia Pedersen put together a piece of music that acknowledges just how spiritual music is, how much we need it, how much we need to reclaim the ability to sing. So the choir is going to lead us in this introit that Lydia wrote, but we're going to put the words up. First of all, because we think the words are beautiful, but also because as we sing, you might like to sing along with us.
God's people need to lift their hearts in song. But through our tongues we're still the Spirit prayed. For us in sighs too deep for words and stayed. Close by our side until the night gave way to radiant morning light. And in the storm's retreat the Spirit bade us sing once more robust and unafraid. With thankful hearts and voices glad and free, we bless the source of rhyme and melody.
Band here today. Now somebody might wonder why we would have a band here today. Well, this is a band that has a special relationship with us because they have used our church for some rehearsal time. We also know some of the members of the band. We also know that they love to make music. And as I said a few minutes ago, music is spiritual. And so it seemed appropriate as we got to Christ the King Sunday that we need to do some celebrating. We truly need to raise our voices and be joyous, especially as we reclaim the gift of music in our lives. So I would like to introduce the Baytowne Big Band, their director, Sarang, and they are going to come in and they are going to lead us in some music. So let us welcome them.
See all of you here, and it's our pleasure to be here this lovely morning, as snowmageddon as it is. Our very first number we're going to do for you, it's based on a very terrific musician who's no longer with us, sadly, Henry Mancini. He was nominated, I believe, for over 72 Grammys, winning about 20 of them in his lifetime, but was nominated for 18 Academy Awards and winning or five of those. And the tune that we're gonna play, our first number, is called Days of Wine and Roses, but we're not gonna play it the way Henry intended. We're gonna play it in the creative hands of Dave Bardoon, who is a terrific arranger, but this is a really swinging arrangement of that very same title. So here's Days of Wine and Roses, as arranged by Dave Bardoon. Here we go.
Thank you.
Thank you so much, and I know there's some more music coming our way. As we gather today, we acknowledge the traditional territory of the Anishinaabeg and Wahtaw First Nation, as well as the traditional lands of the Three Fires Confederacy, the Ojibwe, Odawa, and Potawatomi. We acknowledge that Simcoe Muskoka is the home of many First Nation, Métis, and Inuit people as part of an intricate nationhood that reaches across Turtle Island. And together we say, at this time of truth and reconciliation, we welcome the opportunity to work together toward new understandings and new relationships. We ask for guidance in all that we do. And so we light the fires, the candles of the four directions. Reminding us of our global relationship and that we are indeed part of a global people. We also light the Christ candle to remind us that we are called to be one people, to be light and love in God's world. Amen. Let us join together in singing Psalm 100, Make a Joyful Noise. It's in the hymn book at 820 if you want the music, but the words will be up on the screen. Continue our tradition of greeting each other now, and if you want to greet the band, I'm sure they'd like to be greeted.
When do you think a natural time is for the kids to go?
So we're greeting each other. I'll do the prayer.
Okay.
One more piece of music and then.
Okay. So right after the story. We won't wait for the.
Let us pray. Holy One, God of mystery and creation, you have made us for life and community. God who tends the universe, mending the broken and reconciling the estranged, who enlivens the universe, guiding all things toward harmony with their source. We are grateful for your loving action, and we cannot keep from singing. May we embody the life of Christ in all our living and walk in ways of justice and peace. Mend your world, O God, that your kingdom can truly come into our lives and our world. We ask in the name of the one who preached a radical love for neighbor. Amen. And now we have some more music.
Lemons. It's a term that's often used to things that are sour, but it's also used to describe things that are not working as well, whether it's mechanical or a production or a composition or whatnot. If it's a lemon, it ain't good. And I'm about to tell the reason I mention this is because the next tune that we're going to play is called It's Only a Paper Moon, was based on a musical that was... You guessed it, a lemon. Exactly. That there was a Broadway production called The Great Magoo. However, one of the tunes from that musical, It's Only a Paper Moon, was done by numerous other artists, including Nat King Cole, Benny Goodman, Ella Fitzgerald. In their creative hands, you saw a transformation. You witnessed and you heard a transformation of that tune. I mean, it was absolutely fantastic. We have our very own Janet Ness, who's going to give you a taste of that transformation. So here's Janet Ness singing It's Only a Paper Moon.
Other way.
Oh, right here. There you Thanks. Go.
We don't clutter on here.
Got it. You ready?
Yeah.
Okay, here we go. One, a two, a one, two, three.
Yeah.
Well, there was a hush in the studio. Miss Bellamy's students were all watching her. For once it was quiet, because usually there was a lot of noise with people playing pianos and people in the corner practicing their singing and all kinds of, but everybody hushed because today was the announcement. And Miss Bellamy came out and she looked at everyone and she said, "For the recital, I've decided who the soloist is going to be. Amy Gray." Amy sat there and she thought, me, I get to sing the solo in the recital. That's so exciting. There's going to be a big stage and people and costumes and, oh, I'm so excited. Well, she went home and she told the family and they were excited for her too. And Mom even said, "We're going to get you a new outfit for the show, for the recital." And then she started to practice and the day got closer and closer and Amy got more and more nervous. Instead of a big recital and a big stage, all she could think of is, "I'm going to be up there all by myself on the stage. And what if I lose my voice? What if I make a mistake? Everybody's going to hear it. What if I stumble and fall? What if I do something stupid?" She could hardly hold on. In fact, she thought about getting out of it and just quitting altogether, but Mom said, "No, you're not doing that. You were selected and you put your name forward. You're going to do it and you're going to be fine." Well, they got closer to the day, and Amy just felt sick to her stomach the morning of. She went over to the studio, and she went to the recital hall, and there was Miss Bellamy, and she had her rehearse, and she sang fine, and Miss Bellamy said, "You're fine. Everything's fine." Well, she went backstage, and it was terrible. And she was just about to go back out and say something to Miss Bellamy about having to sing when she heard this funny sound. And she looked, and it was somebody crying. Well, over behind the coat rack, there was little Lizzie, and she was one of the youngest members of the group. And Amy got down beside her and said, "What's wrong, Lizzie? I'm so scared. I don't think I can play the piano today in the recital. I just don't think I can do it." "Sure you can," said Amy. "You'll be just fine." And she tried to think of all the things that Mom had said to her, and she finished off by saying, "And don't forget, your family will always love you no matter what happens." "But that's just the point," said Lizzie. "We don't have a lot of money, and my uncle's coming. And if I play well, he's going to pay for some music lessons. And if not, he probably won't pay for them. So a lot depends on how I play today." And all of a sudden, Amy had an idea. And she said, "You know, you're going to be playing, but there can be two of us in the music. Are you going to come and play with me?" said Lizzie. "No," said Amy, "but I'm going to stand just off the stage where you can see me, and I'm going to hum along while you're playing, and you just keep looking at me when you sit down, and then you just concentrate on the music, and don't forget, music is about everybody, so I'm going to be in the music with you, and you just think about that when you're playing." Well, Lizzie got called, and she went out on the stage, and she played beautifully. And when she was finished, everybody got up and gave her a standing ovation. And she came off the stage and she hugged Amy. She says, "Thank you so much." And just then, they called Amy. Amy thought, "I forgot to be scared." And she went out on the stage and she sang beautifully. And everybody gave her applause too. And later, when she saw Lizzie later, she said, "Thank you, Lizzie." Lizzie said, "For what?" She said, "Because you made me think of something more than me. And with the music, we got involved in the music and we forgot to be scared." "You're right," said Lizzie. And off they went for ice cream. Amen. Let's join together in our next hymn.
Praise the Lord with the harp and lute. Praise the Lord with the gentle sounding flute.
you ever met anyone that's come across the show with hammers? Okay, so we are all humble. When we come across them and we are humble by their presence, I'll bet you are all tongue-tied and you just don't know. You want to ask them, we'll pepper them with lots of questions. You don't know what to ask them, right? So it's happened to all of us. And a show of hands again, who's a big fan of Barbara Streisand? Well, guess what? She's not here this morning. But we have something very, very close. From the Academy Award-winning movie and the score written for it, Barbara Streisand had sang The Way We Were, composed by Marvin Hamlisch. Since she is not here, we have our own Shelley Charlebois on lead trombone, who is going to play The Way We Were for all of you. And it is a beautiful, beautiful ballet, and we hope you all enjoy it. Here we go.
What is written in the Bible, listen now for the meaning these words hold for you. After Samuel, our reading is from 1 Samuel chapter 16, verses 14 to 23, David and Saul, a paraphrase. After Samuel anointed David, God's spirit departed from Saul, and an evil spirit tormented him. Saul's servants said to him, "Look, an evil spirit is tormenting you. If our master just says the word, your servants will search for someone who knows how to play the lyre. The musicians can play whatever, whenever the evil spirit is affecting you, and then you'll feel better." Saul said to his servants, "Find me a good musician and bring him to me." One of the servants responded, "I know that one of Jesse's sons from Bethlehem is a good musician. He's a strong man and heroic, a warrior who speaks well and is good-looking too. Yahweh is with him." So Saul sent messengers to Jesse to say, "Send me your son David, the one who keeps the sheep." Jesse then took a donkey and loaded it with a homer of bread, a jar of wine, and a young goat, and he sent it along with his son David to Saul. That is how David came to Saul and entered his service. Saul liked David very much, and David became his armor bearer. Saul sent a message to Jesse, "Please allow David to remain in my service because I am pleased with him." Whenever the evil spirit affected Saul, David would take up the lyre and play it. Then Saul would relax and feel better, and the depression and sadness would leave him alone. May the Spirit bless us with wisdom and wonder as we ponder the meaning for these words for our lives. Thanks be to God.
Going from the last number we played, the way we were, we often yearn for things that are not complex anymore, such as rotary phones. I mean, have you ever tried to hang up on a person you are ticked off with nowadays on a cell phone? You miss the slam. You can't do that with an Android phone. Smarter than you are, and it's more expensive than you are. We miss VCRs with a flashing 12 because our parents never learned how to properly set the timer. We also miss neighbors popping by to our houses unannounced, and they're readily welcomed in our home for immediate socials of tea and cookies and whatnot. And by extension, mom's and grandma's apple pie that's cooling by the open window. And so for these very, very simple things in life that we miss, this is what our next tune is about. It's sung by a great number of jazz artists, including Bing Crosby, Tony Bennett, and even Ella Fitzgerald. And it's her version of Give Me the Simple Life that our lovely Janet Ness is going to sing for you next.
One, two, three, four, one, two, okay?
I don't know about you, but I'm loving the music this morning. Now, I had asked Janet if she would come up and talk to me this morning, and we were going to sit on stools up here at the front, but that's not going to happen. But and she has found her way past all the drums, and she is up here. Welcome, Janet.
Thank you.
Most of you have met Janet, but mostly behind the piano over there and with a mask on. So I want you to take a good look at Janet because you get to see her today without a mask on.
Sorry.
So this is good. Janet came to join us last spring as our music director to lead the choir, to play the music. So we have been enjoying the music, Janet, for some time. But we haven't really... had a chance to talk to you. So I thought today, when we're celebrating music, this would be a good time. And I'm thinking about something that you said when you first came to us and you and I were chatting about the place of music in a worship service. And I want you to recount for me sort of that approach to music that you take in worship.
Well, when I was, this isn't going to take a very long time, but when I was 10, my dad and I started singing in the Vase United Church Choir, which is Unity United Church now, when we moved to our farm when I was 10. And so music has been part of church forever for me. I've never not been in a music choir. I've never not been asked to play for certain events or, you know, special services or whatever. So it's been part of my life forever. But when I was at Northwest, I was at Northwest Barrie for almost 20 years as their music director, and Tom Lowry, we built the church and we built the music program, and it was wonderful. But at the same time, Wynn and I were building a family, and I was building a music studio. And so back in 2013, something kind of had to give. And so I retired from my position at Northwest Barrie United Church, only to realize that music in church and playing so that people can lift up their voices in song, that is how I worship. That's how I worship. So when I sit and play the piano for you before church, or when I sit and play and you guys are singing gustily or clapping on beats 1 and 3 instead of 2 and 4, then, you know, that's how I worship. And it is integral to me. It's completely integrated in church for me. If music, you know, sitting in the pews is wonderful, and thank heavens we have people who sit in the pews. But when I retired, that wasn't enough. And so in December of 2013, Tom Lowry, who had moved to the terraces with his wife Irene and was very active in the Painswick United Church.
No, wait a minute. You retired for how long? 6 months?
Maybe not even.
Okay,
almost
keep going.
Sort of. You know, and I really missed it. However, Tom asked me, could I come? Their musician was ill. Could I come and cover for 2 weeks? So 8 years later, we finished, unfortunately, you know, COVID and aging leadership had took its toll on Painswick, and we closed our doors. And then that was in September of last year. And I believe through Nancy Drury, a mutual friend, said, well, you know, they need somebody at Grace to play Thanksgiving. And I came here and played, and it had been a long time since I'd played in for people, because at, you know, for 2 years we had just done recorded things at home and I'd sent them to people for Painswick. And to come back and be able to play for people, and then that Sunday that we, you know, you guys all started to sing again, it felt right. And that's worship for me.
Well, thank you, Janet. What kind of music do you like?
Oh, all sorts. I love what you guys are doing. I played tenor sax and trumpet in stage band all the way through high school, and I was trained classically through the Royal Conservatory. Excuse me. So I love that too, but I'm a big Elton John fan, and I'm a big Billy Joel fan, so folk, anything. I'm, you know, almost anything.
Thank you, Jan. And we were reminded in Scripture this morning that music, it's good for us to be worshiping and celebrating God through music, but we heard the story of David playing for Saul, because music also has a therapeutic quality, doesn't it?
Oh, completely. I run a music studio, and I work with a lot of people who have special needs, a lot of anxiety issues, people on the spectrum, a couple of young people with Down syndrome, and they walk in the door, maybe they've had a rough day at school or somebody said something yucky to them or whatever, and we spend half an hour or 45 minutes together, and they go out and they're laughing and there's joy. And I see it at choir Thursday nights. For, you know, you might be surprised to know that some of them have to drag the rear ends to get here on a Thursday because they're tired.
You're saying the choir's kind of grumpy at
maybe,
times?
Maybe, right. When they walk in, you know, sometimes, looking at no one in particular, and, you know, and then we sing together, and we make music, and we harmonize, and it's a beautiful thing, and you can just feel the energy. I mean, you can feel the energy in here today,
yeah,
right?
Yeah,
and then the different energy when you did the way we were, and that was beautiful. And, you know, it just, yeah, it's very transformative.
Now, if you were going to play a piece of music for us, what would you pick?
Well, in a normal church service, I don't know.
We're not normal.
and that's a good thing, because I haven't picked a typical one today.
All right.
I'm going to play a favorite Billy Joel piece of mine.
Okay.
Okay. Piano Man.
Thank
once
you, Janet.
Once I get back to the piano.
Thank you so much, Janet. We're going to receive our offering now. We're not going to do it quite the way we normally do it. We're not going to bring the plates to the front because there really isn't a place to put them. But I will invite our ushers to receive the offering now and once collected, put the plates at the back.
Thank you.
acknowledge today that the bulletin is dedicated in memory of Don Lynn. I think because this is an anniversary coming up of his birthday, but this is a service he would have loved because he loved music. And so I'm certainly pleased that today we are acknowledging the bulletin in his memory. Let us pray. We give thanks, O God, for all that you offer to us through life, through friendships, through community, through music. We give thanks for the opportunities we have to share in your world, to be part of your effort to mend our world, to bring us together in harmony as one people. We ask your blessing on people who struggle, who seek to find their way. May they feel the comfort and support of your presence. We pray for those places in our world where there is heartache, warfare, violence, death. May we be peacemakers and may we find ways to come together as your people. Loving God, as we move into the days of the coming week, may we feel your presence walking with us, opening our hearts to others, leading us in ways that are kind and compassionate, finding solutions and reconciliation, being your people, reflecting your love in the world. This we pray in the name of Jesus. Amen. And some more special music.
I noticed early in the service this morning that you all had a chance to make joyful music, a little joyful noise, and that's what we would like to do next for you, our version of it. And it's quite appropriate because it's rather gospel in nature. It has nothing to do with the title of the tune, but it is the way we play it. The original version, this is called Groove Merchant, was done by Jerome Richardson, a saxophone player, and with Thad Jones' orchestra. He wrote out this beautiful sax, killer sax soli lick that is extremely difficult to pull off. And it would have required rehearsals well into the new year for us to pull it off. So in its place, what we're going to do is the same tune, but done in a gospel rock kind of fashion. And it's arranged by Rich Sigler, and it's called Groove Merchant. So if you feel like you need to get up and dance, we have no objection.
Thank you.
If you are all so inclined as we are, we would like to do one additional number towards the end of the service.
Yeah.
Is that all right with everybody? Okay.
That would be fabulous. Well, we're going to sing a hymn right now and do the benediction, and then we're going to go back to the band for another piece of music. Today we're going to sing the I'm Gonna Live, which we usually use for the offertory, and we only do two verses. Today we're going to sing the whole hymn, so come on, stand up and let's sing. Let us go out embracing the present, embodying hope, loving our enemies, caring for the earth, and choosing life. Grateful for God's loving action, we cannot keep from singing. Let us go in peace. Amen. And I'm going to turn things back to the band now to be our choral benediction. But before I do that, I just want to say again how much we appreciate the music. It being a snowy day, I know some of you had to drive a bit of a distance to get here. And thank you so much. And if at some point you want to let us know where the places you're going to be performing, we'd be happy to share that information.
For our last number, I just want to say thank God. And I'm going to let that sink in for a minute. But, and when you reflect on that, I don't want you to reflect on the reason why you think. But thank God that Halloween is over. A few weeks ago, I'm driving on 26 out of Stayner, made a right turn to go towards Collingwood, and on the left-hand side, there's a Fernwood Farmer's Market. You all are probably familiar with that, right? I know Jill and Scott are. We turn in to buy our fall-themed specials for post-Thanksgiving, pumpkin sort of thing. But to my horror, on the left-hand side, I see this, I wish I had a picture I was hoping to show you on the big screen, but it's not possible. A giant teepee of sorts made with long wooden sticks. It looks like a teepee, but there's no outer covering. But there are shelves all along the teepee, and on each of these rungs are pumpkins. So the whole thing looked like a pumpkin Christmas tree. And I said, wait a second, Halloween's not over. Why are you putting up Christmas stuff right now? And we see this wherever we go, including the dollar store, for example. Prior to Halloween being over, there are orange and black aisles that have paraphernalia, especially the candies, and right next to them there's a red and a green aisles for the Christmas themed stuff, and there are candies over there. And I'm thinking, wait, you've got Halloween candies and one's got Christmas themed candies on the other side. Who came up with this marketing ploy? We have been hammered our childhood through television commercials that 4 out of 5 dentists recommend that Trident sugarless gum is better for your teeth. And I have often wondered, what about that fifth guy, the lone holdout? What's his deal? Well, I think it's a marketing ploy, obviously, to generate more income for the dentistry industry. And that is why wherever they can pack in more sugary stuff so that you can go ahead and buy it, it will generate more income for them. But I digress, because thank God Halloween is over. And so it is the perfect time now to have to visit those red and green aisles and have your fill with Christmas decor. And to help get you in that mood, we do not have Mel Torme or Nat King Cole around here anymore, but we do have our lovely Janet Nest to take you there, and in the spirit of the festive season that is just around the corner.
Thank you.
And
I just want to take the time to thank all the members of our band here. Starting in the rhythm section to your left, we've got Ralph Johnson on bass, Bruce Campbell on drums, Eugene Dion on auxiliary percussion, Jay Rothenberg, who helped fill us in for the last minute on piano. Back in the trumpet section, we have Daryl Yeager, Renee Montreux, and Scott Witt. On the trombone section, we have Alan Doucette, we have Bill Ritchie, Leon Rogers, Shelley Charlebois, Jill Morrison, and oh yeah, us guys, right. To your right, my left, Scott Morrison, see, mom, daughter, look, mom's son is right there, mom's son, right over there. They came in the same car. Scott Morrison on tenor sax, Lacey Marshall on tenor sax, Rick Singer on baritone sax. That's quite a big, heavy thing to take home. Needs a dolly. Scott Allington on alto, and myself, I'm Saran Kulkarni, also on alto. Thank you very much for joining us this morning. We had lots of fun here.
And before we give you some applause, speaking of sweet treats, everyone's invited for a coffee hour, and perhaps the band can stay and have some coffee with us and some refreshments, and we can have some conversation.
That would be lovely.
Thank you again so much to the band.